Thank you. a horrible way to lose a game of football, a penalty shootout.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it's never easy. Unfortunately, we've had it twice already this season, so I hope we don't have any more. So many positives that we can take out. The big thing for me is the way the task have been disciplined, because they're a good side. They're great movement, good passing side. We've stuck to our jobs, worked extremely hard. I think the fitness levels were tremendous throughout the game. You look and there's quite a few of them going down with cramp, and we were still going strong. So that's a pleasing thing. But we've come up against a team of very, very good footballers, regardless of the fact they're not their first choice players. They've shown there, people like Healy, Garvin, the young striker. I mean, for 16-year-old, what a fantastic talent he looks. And you know, we haven't done ourselves any harm playing in that. Just the disappointment is we've lost the game.
Yeah, there's a lot of talk before the match about the changes that Roy Keane would make, but you know, any side that he puts out is going to be good.
Well, you know they're going to be committed, that's without a doubt, and you just have to see him roaring them from the side and giving the orders out to them. You know they're going to be committed, but you also know any player that comes through Ipswich's youth system, they can pass the ball, they've got good movement, they've got a good awareness of how to play the game, and I think they've shown that tonight.
I expect one of the main positives you can take out of that is resilience to twice come back from falling behind.
Yeah, it's shown good character. Everything about our performance and I'm delighted with, apart from obviously the penalty shootout. You know, we've missed two tonight, which has cost us it. But there's a hell of a lot of good things. But we have to make sure we keep the positives and we use them for the weekend game, because, you know, unfortunately, we're out of the cup now. We've got to forget about this competition, and we concentrate now on going to Barnet, making sure we go and perform and work the way that we have done against a good Ipswich side tonight. And if we do that, then we shouldn't go far wrong.
I'd imagine the performances of the likes of Shane Cansdell-Sherriff and Brighton Reese are off the bench has given you some nice selection headaches for Saturday.
Great problems to have. That's what I want it to be. You know, there's some tired legs tonight, but Chris has come off the bench. I thought Nathan Elder's worked extremely hard. He's got another goal, which won't do him any harm. Shane Cansdell-Sherriff has come into it and performed very well. Disley's finding his feet. Josh Labbard is to come back in at the weekend. Stephen Leslie's now available after his suspension. So we're starting to get more and more bodies available to us. And the more the merrier, because we're going to need them.
Does it help that Barnet have also gone into time this evening?
I could probably answer that on Saturday, but I don't think I can answer that one now. All we can concern ourselves with our players, and we make sure they're all right. They're back in tomorrow morning. We'll get them all sorted out to start again on Thursday, with a view to preparing for Barnet away.
What do you think you can expect from them?
A tough game. Yeah, they're always full of life, especially on their own pitch. They've got pace in wide areas, and we need to be on our game. We've shown tonight against a good championship group of players that we can hold our own with 3-3 after 120 minutes. Now we have to go and make sure we do it against a lively Barnet side and get back to our bread and butter, which is League Two, and hopefully get the points on the board again.
Bad luck tonight. Thanks for your time, Paul.
Thank you.
Also had chances tonight. If we'd taken them, could have been different.
Yeah, we had a couple of other chances as well. I mean, we scored three goals. And good goals as well. Dave Hibbert is an absolute world striker. It's an outstanding piece of ability to stick that one in. And the other two goals are good footballing moves. So I'm delighted with the football we've played, the goals we've scored. Disappointed that we've conceded three goals at home and in the manner that we have. But we've been shown again that if you don't get tight with quality footballers, they cause you a problem. And that young 16-year-old kid, I'd need to check that passport, because if he's 16, he is one fantastic talent to look forward to watching.
And all games about taking positives, and there's a lot you can take from this.
Hell of a lot of positives we take out of it. Really, there's the negatives, if I'm going to be honest. But unfortunately, we've still lost the game. We've still got nothing out of it. And we've got to make sure we keep our heads and we go into the next game and we deal with the next one properly. And if we can get 3 points on the road on Saturday, then we can put this one to bed straight away.
As you mentioned before, it's about the players and the squad. And tonight is showing that. I'm say Shane coming in.
Yes, Shane coming in. Chris Bright now getting involved because his clearance has come through. A hell of a lot of good things tonight. I'm delighted with the way that everybody's stuck to it. Omar's come off the bench, Chris has come off the bench, and then Terry Dunfield's come into it. So that's pleasing. And the more players we can get available, the better it'll be for us.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.